I've got an example here of a user form. I'm going to assume that you have basic knowledge of user forms. What we're going to be doing in this example is creating a user form for capital cost estimation of heat exchangers. And cost of a heat exchanger in industry depends upon capacity, type of heat exchanger, the pressure rating, the length of the tubes, material of construction, and then time. Over time, the cost of a heat exchanger is going to change essentially because of inflation. We can come up with an equation for the purchase cost, CP. It's a function of a bunch of different factors, including the base cost. Equations are published for the base cost of heat exchangers, depending upon if it's a floating head type, a fixed head type, or a U-tube type. You can see that each of these equations is a function of area. So if we increase the area, that will increase the base cost. The pressure factor is given by this simple equation, and that accounts for any changes in pressures. We've also got this tube length factor, FL. Finally, we have the material factor. So we can put these values of A and B into this equation for the material factor, and now we know the pressure factor, material factor, length factor, and the base cost. There's one more thing that we haven't taken into account, and that is the effect of time. And over time, you have inflation, and we have these chemical engineering cost index that increases, and you basically just increase the cost that you calculated in the previous equations by a certain factor. All the previous equations for the base cost or the purchase cost assume a CE index of 500. This is just a sketch of what we envision the user form to look like. We have a choice of the type. The user can input the area, they can input the year, they can select the material of construction. There's a go button, a reset button, and a quit button. When they run this form, it will come up with a purchase cost, and we can either design this so the purchase cost box comes up in a separate message box, or actually what I'm going to do is put that into the form. So I've designed the heat exchanger user form. I've named it main form, and I've got all the different options here for material, for type. I've got a box for area. Down here on the left, you can set default values. Tube length, you can set default values of radio buttons by the value down here, changing it from false to true. And because it's in a frame, that means only one of those radio buttons can be true at any given time. And then I've got an output price. Instead of using a message box to output the price, I've got just a text field here. And when they click calculate price, it's going to put the price into this box. I've also got a reset field and a quit button. You'll notice that I've named everything. So here I have floating head, that's a Boolean. Fixed head, U-tube. Area is named area. I've got pressure, year. And similarly, I've done this for everything else. The first thing you want to do is you want to make the quit button. The quit button just looks like this. You unload the main form. The reset button is just you unload the main form. That will actually clear everything you've put in, reset it to its default, and then we're going to reshow the main form. So we have to have this main form.show. Now let's talk about doing all the calculations. And remember, we had all those cost equations that depend upon all sorts of different factors: pressure, area, the type, the material, and then we account for inflation. So if I click on calculate price, double click on the border here, I've got some input validation in here, and I've got different scenarios. So if they choose floating head, then you have a certain equation for the floating head, base cost, fixed head, different base cost. Those are just the equations and the U-tube. And then we have the pressure factor, and that's just given by the equation. And you'll notice that this pressure corresponds to, in the form, the pressure here. So that's how we can use the inputs in a calculation. Depending upon if they selected 8 feet, 12 feet, 16 feet, and 20 feet for the length of the tubes, then we've got different length factors. And then we've got the material factor calculations, where depending upon what they choose as the material for the shell and tubes, we have different values of A and B that go into that equation. At the end of this, we calculate the material factor depending upon A and B, and then we account for time. If they selected 2004, We account for the cost factors in 2004 compared to 2006, which is when those cost equations were four. And then finally, we assign price to, I'm rounding the purchase cost to zero decimal places. And again, this price, we don't have to dim it because it's actually already named here. Lastly, I've just created a button here in developer, insert button, and I've formatted it. So this is assigned to the macro. The macro that we've created is a sub here, and all we're doing is we're showing the main form. So that button is linked to the heat exchanger macro or sub. So when we run this, the user can input area, so I can change different things here, calculate price, and it outputs the price right here in the box. And I can reset fields and so on.